Pat Summitt took women's basketball and by herself elevated it to an incredible level. No other coach has ever impacted a sport the way that she impacted women's basketball. But again, she impacted people well beyond sports. You know, again, I've been around intense coaches. I myself am competitive to a fault, but I loved watching Pat Summitt coach because of how competitive she was. She didn't request excellence, she demanded it. And every player she touched, every person she touched, took a little bit of that with them, having known her.
With Pat, there was a trust. She trusted you to do your very best, and we trusted her to always be that iconic leader that she was. She loved us unconditionally, and we in turn loved her the same. So it's great to celebrate the basketball coach, but it's much more important to celebrate the person who spent her life making a difference for all of us.
The thing that I remember most, and there's so many, obviously we worked together for 33 years, when she was diagnosed with this disease, she looked me, she didn't give me the stare, but she looked me directly in the eye and she said, "Joan, I thought I was going to be remembered for winning basketball games, but I hope I'm remembered to make a difference in this disease." So if you ask Joan Cronin what she's been doing mostly the last 3 years, it's raising money for the Pat Summitt Foundation, because I think she wanted to make a difference in this disease. You know, we always knew Pat as a great coach. We always knew Pat as the stare and the integrity and all of those wonderful things that we can do. But what she showed me the last 5 years is that she's a woman of courage. She faced this disease straight on. Never once had a pity pack party. Never once said, "Why me?" But she said, "I want to make a difference." And that's the way she faced coaching basketball. It was always straightforward, always positive. So, you know, I have nothing but just wonderful memories of Pat.
It's an honor to had an opportunity to know someone like her. And, you know, I got to see her in different ways, being a former player. I got to see her intensity, I'm just gonna call it intensity. And then coming back on staff, I got to really see her as the woman and the mom and the wife, and just in a totally different way than I did as a player. And we're all going to be responsible to carry this charge. And we live by a code. And I know everybody talks about the definite dozen, but it's why we were able to get through this time together over these past 4 or 5 days in this going home process. And there were so many players from different eras that, again, everybody knows that once a Lady Vol, always a Lady Vol, but so many people came together, and that was her doing that to make it easier for us, if you will, to be able to handle all of this. And that was her last gift, if you will, to us.
I will say this, y'all know Pat. Pat's been a competitor forever. And I was coming up here today and I was thinking, you know, everything that everyone said has just been fantastic and very heart thought. But Pat and Mickey and I've been around I've been with Pat for a long time. I played for 4 years, obviously, and then came back, and she and Mickey and I have a really, we always had a really strong bond, and we used to go running every day, and we ran and we would talk, but Pat always had to be just a little bit in front of Mickey and I, just a little, and Mickey and I kind of, I'd be behind her, I said, I'm gonna speed up a little bit and see if I can get ahead of Summitt. Well, Summitt would speed up a little bit more, and we're like, come on, Pat, can you give the competition a rest a little bit? And we'd be close to the arena or when we were at Stokely, and she would just take off sprinting to where we would end. So needless to say, Mickey and I never beat Coach Summitt in a jog. But that's how she was. She's just competitive in everything she did and had a tremendous sense of humor. And I think what I would tell coaches is what Pat has taught me. It's not about you. It's not about you. It's about what you're doing for these young women that you promised their parents you would take care of.